Hi, in this video, I'm going to explain you what is P, NP, NP complete and NP hard problems in computer science world. To explain P, NP and others, let's use the same terminologies we use to classify the problems in real life. In most of the cases, we use easy to hard scale. In theoretical computer science, the classification and the complexity of common problem definitions have two major sets, P, which is a polynomial time, and NP, which is non-deterministic polynomial time. There are also NP hard and NP complete sets. Now, if we label them based on the easy to hard scale, we can say P is nothing but easy, NP is medium, NP complete is hard, and NP hard is the hardest. From the diagram, it is clear that P and NP are not the same set, but still it is an open problem to prove P is indeed equal to NP, and that is called as a million-dollar question. In theoretical computer science world, we use big O notation in order to express the time complexity of any given problem instead of units like seconds and milliseconds. Common values for big O notation are constant time, log time, linear time, quadratic time, polynomial time, exponential time, and factorial time. In these notations, k is a constant and n indicates the input size. The first set of problems are polynomial algorithms that we can solve in a polynomial time like log time, linear time, or quadratic time. If an algorithm is polynomial, then we can formally define its time complexity as big O of c into n raised to k, where c and k are constants, they are greater than 0, and n is the input size. Also, we expect k should be less than n. Now, there are many algorithms which complete in a polynomial time, like all basic mathematical operations like addition, subtraction, testing of primacy, hash table lookup, string operations, sorting problems, shortest path algorithms like Dijkstra's, Bellman-Ford, or Floyd-Warshall, linear and binary search algorithms. These all are algorithms which complete in a polynomial time. It is not necessary that input should be only one, that is n. For example, in the case of the graph, the time complexity depends upon number of edges and number of vertices. The time complexity is big O of e into v. For example, in the Bellman-Ford shortest path algorithm, till the e and v are to be solved in a polynomial time, their multiplication will also be the polynomial time. It is not necessary that the input size is n, then the problem will be in the polynomial algorithm case. For example, in the case of the checkerboard problem, if the board is of size 8x8, then it is believed to be the polynomial time problem. But if the board is of size n x n, then it is no longer a polynomial algorithm. One last point, if the k and n are almost equal, then the time complexity of that problem becomes exponential rather than the polynomial. And hence, that problem cannot be considered as a polynomial algorithm. The second set of problems that cannot be solved in polynomial time, but they can be verified in polynomial time. For example, a Sudoku that cannot be solved in polynomial time, but if user plays all the values, then it can be verified in a polynomial time. Such algorithms are called as NP algorithm, that is non-deterministic polynomial algorithms. We expect these algorithms to have an exponential complexity defined as big O of C1 into k raised to c2 into n, where c1, c2 and k are greater than 0 and are constants, where n is the input size. We expect at least c1 and c2 should be equal to 1. All the problems with the time complexity as big O of n raised to n, 2 raised to n or 2 raised to m into n are belonging to this kind of a set. For example, the algorithms that fits in this description are integer factorization, graph isomorphism. Two important characteristics that define a problem is an NP problem. First, the time complexity is exponential. Second, the results can be verified in polynomial time. The NP complete set is very much similar to the previous set, that is NP. By the diagram, it was clear all the problems which belongs to NP complete are also belonging to NP, but they are among the hardest in the set. What makes them different from other NP problems is a useful distinction called as completeness. For any NP problems that is complete, there exists a polynomial time algorithm that transforms the problem into any other NP complete problem. This transformation requirement is also called as reduction. There are numerous NP problems proven to be complete. Among them are traveling salesman problem, knapsack problem, and graph coloring problem. What they have in common is, aside from being NP, they can be reduced into other NP complete problems in polynomial time. Last set of problems contains the hardest, most complex problems in computer science, called as NP hard algorithms. They are not only hard to solve, but are hard to verify as well. In fact, some of these problems are even not decidable. Among the hardest computer science problems are K-means clustering, traveling salesman problem, and graph coloring. Now, these algorithms have property similar to that ones of the NP complete. That means they can be reduced into any problem in NP. And hence, there is a debate that TSP problem is indeed NP complete problem or not. A million-dollar question, also called as Millennium Prize problem, is P is indeed equal to NP or not? Because if it is proven, then one can say NP or NP complete problem can be solved in polynomial time. To conclude this video, we saw the problems in the computer science can be divided into different problem sets: P, NP, NP complete, and NP hard. We can say P problems are quick to solve. NP problems are quick to verify but slow to solve. NP complete problems are also quick to verify, slow to solve, and can be reduced to any other NP complete problem. NP hard problems are slow to verify, slow to solve, and can be reduced to any other NP problem. As a final note, if P is equal to NP has a proof in the future, then NP, NP complete problems can be solved in a polynomial time. Thank you. See you in the next video.